Hello, Capricorn. Welcome to your weekly tarot reading with me, Sarah from Divinely You. I appreciate you guys so much for tuning in and watching these videos. So let's dive right into this Capricorn reading for this week. We got the Lovers. And I knew I would forget which one of these I drew. The Two of Air. I always forget the numbers. And then the Awakening card. So let's take a look, shall we? All right, there we go. Perfect. Okay, so Capricorn, what I'm feeling here is you got the Lovers card, which is totally brilliant, right? Because you got a lot of love energy coming your way in multiple ways. But what I'm feeling like is these other, the Awakening and the Air card are suggesting that you're having difficulty making, which sort of made me think, are you wearing rose-colored goggles? Are you like totally infatuated with a new partner? Are you totally infatuated with your current partner? Or maybe even a crush, and you're putting on rose-colored goggles and you're having difficulty making a decision. Like, you've got the capability of choosing, but something's holding you back from choosing. I don't know. I just feel like this is, you're wearing, maybe it's too good to be true and you're just unsure. Or maybe it's you're not paying attention to a detail, or you're not in tune or attentive to maybe like you don't see the red flags. There was an old saying that was like, when you're wearing rose-colored goggles, the red flags look white. And so we can totally misinterpret something that may be a red flag, or that, you know, because we're so infatuated, or we're so just into this new person or an existing person, that we can't even see the potential drawbacks to that relationship, right? Or the things in the relationship that are maybe compromising or complicated. And maybe that's what's standing in your way of whatever the next decision is for you. Or are you losing focus on what you're up to outside of the relationship? You know, relationships can get to be all consuming in the beginning, or even in the middle, or, you know, towards the end. If it's not a healthy relationship, and maybe it is, and maybe you're like, dang, I'd rather be with the person than anything else in my life. And you can't decide to make that commitment. Maybe you want to make the commitment, but the other person isn't ready to make the commitment. Who knows? I'm just speculating here, but just based on like the decision-making in both of these cards, plus the Lovers card, like, and maybe relationships are growing in other ways. Like, this does not have to be a romantic situation. Maybe this is a friendship that, you're just like, this is too distracting, or, I can't handle that. Or maybe you're not seeing something about that. I don't know. There's just something about like, you're not seeing something in that relationship or in that other person that's a red flag, but you're not seeing it. And maybe you're concerned that you're not seeing it. Maybe it's like I said, maybe it's a too good to be true situation, and you're like, what am I not paying attention to? So you're like digging for it. So you're afraid to make a decision based on that. So I don't know, Capricorns, but I would take a cold, hard look at what is the relationship situation, because it's affecting your decision-making clarity. And from the Believe in Your Own Magic, we got Mourning, which is the world awaits you. The world is awaiting you. So the world's waiting for you to make a decision, or maybe your world is waiting for you to make a decision. So wake up, get after it, make that choice. See those red flags if you need to, or look, maybe you need to just take a step back to really see what's going on in your life that's like not working, or that you need to choose a different way of interacting in your world, or a different way of like balancing your world. So thank you so much, Capricorn, for tuning in this week. I appreciate you. If you're not already, you can follow me on Instagram, Sarah Divinely You. And if you would like a private reading, you can email me below and request that private reading. And thank you so much for tuning in. Sending y'all a ton of love with the Lover's card. That's kind of funny. All right. I'll talk to you guys next week. Thank you. Take care. Love you.